Hello everyone, this is Don playing Minecraft with the mod pack All the Mods 5, and this is episode 9. Welcome to our adventure. We are progressing with the tech mods. We're trying to get into immersive engineering, and we're getting there. Basically, we got the coke oven and the reinforced blast furnace. Not powered, just in order to get access to extract items from it. And we finally got the press, the immersive engineering press for the plates. Yeah, there are mods that can do it easier, but I made a full basement big room just for immersive machinery, and I'm gonna try and see if that works. If it doesn't, then you know, it happens. We'll swap or we'll change or we'll do whatever it needs we need to do. But for the moment, I am trying to get the machines from that mod, because they're visually appealing to me, and I know that it's a lot of work to do that, and they're multi-blocks and stuff. It's not easy, but you know, I also placed some elevators here so I can get out of the house faster. And yeah, so we'll start doing more progression with the immersive engineering. Okay, so alright, so relay goes here. You. Voila. Now, if I were to so crafter into a chest and the crafter can have that. And when I craft copper, it's missing. Oh, I see. I don't know how to get rid of that, because the press is not okay. Let's say it's like this, right? So any kind of copper gives me a plate. How? One of you. Okay. Cancel. Alright. Well, that was easy. Just don't shift click. Alright, so now, if I want copper plates, wait, did I? Yeah, start. Yeah, I got 8 in there, but it doesn't want to put them in there. And it has power. Can be here, and how is this going to be? No, not good. Yeah, so that means the chest has to be there. Chest. Crafter, yeah, and cable, and you. I need to cancel the job. Okay. Okay. So. Okay, but this one should pick them up. Isn't that your purpose, Hover? Oh my god, do I seriously have to make another chest? Nothing wants to interact. Nothing wants to interact anymore. Yeah, that there. Says vacuum up nearby items and put them in an inventory. There. Oh, now it's glowing. Really, you didn't detect a freaking inventory? There. Copper. 7. Alright, so the system works, not very good looking. I mean, the whole purpose was to make it nice, right? Because we could make all this in one block with thermal. But the whole point was the visual part. So. I don't know if I want to invest into the other ones, like the diesel generator and so forth. The quarry. Yeah. Yeah. I can make a iron. An iron plate, electrum hammer. There you go. And then I can make you with you. And voila. And electrum. Equals one electrum plate. And then I can go here to where I have my plates, and for example, if I want 4 iron plates, oh no, this is absorbing the items before they land. Plate. Go. Okay. I still have diesel. Still have energy. What's up with that? 0 out of 256 flux. No, capacitor is full. What is this? It's your own freaking cable. This is your cable. Jesus Christ. Why are you not connecting? So you are connecting. Oh my. Wait. This is full, yeah. Okay. I forgot. Output. Stupid. No. Wait a minute. If I did that, come on. Oh. If I did this, would it work? Whoa. I meant this and this. Would it work? Yes, it works. Amazing. Doesn't look good. I'm gonna move it. Just gonna cancel this. And see it working. Plate. Go. Go, go, plates. Okay guys, so we got it to work. It was a bit confusing because it can't really do it like I used to do it, so I don't know the new process. Basically, I used to drop or not drop, I used to put a hopper on the belt and it automatically placed it in the item form like that already, so it wasn't flowing there. And now it doesn't seem to work that way because you can't really interact with the belt anymore. Even if you want to right click an item on it, it doesn't work. For example, see, if I'm right clicking, nothing happens, but if I throw it, it picks it up. So I'm assuming that's a change, and I'm concerned about this because let's say you want 64 plates. By the time this machine processes 50 or 30 or how many it does, the items standing right here might despawn. So I don't know. Maybe the belt has some kind of feature to not let items despawn on it, but I don't know what to say. It's a concern that I have. So, but yeah, it's a functional plate maker, right? So we just need to make more templates, put them in the crafter, and it's good to go. But it's still a concern. In the back of my mind, I still have to think about that. So whenever I process lots of plates, I need to either go check or investigate a little bit in the beginning, at least, just to make sure that it's not causing any issues. My game froze. Okay. So yeah, I don't know what else to say. It's functional. So we're gonna keep it because we did all this struggle to get it working. But if it presents any kind of problems or we see anything wrong with it, we're gonna swap to thermal one block machine. You put it there, put templates there, job done. It's less complicated and a lot more efficient. So yeah, I think I made I did make the templates over here. I did fill in some more templates, including for the solar panels that I made. I auto-crafted them. I made all the required templates for the 64K storage disk, and then I made some more templates for the solar panel tier 6, which provides 2048 Fe per tick, or RF is the same thing. And two of them provide 4096. So that's exactly how much the extractor from Immersive Engineer requires. So we're gonna attempt to make the extractor and see how that works and if it works. At the same time, we need some sort of ender chest capability to get it in our base, in our system, from wherever we're mining, right? Because we're not gonna make pipes all the way from there. So I can make chests, ender chests, which are amazing, and I'm gonna keep them on the white as the default, because that's always my go-to colors for the input chest. So in other words, I need an importer, which I also made a template for, and all the materials required. Oh, the 64Ks are finished. Alright, that's nice. I thought it was going to take longer. And the importer, nice. So now we can expand our storage even more, and we're going to replace the 4Ks with 64s along the way, but I don't know how many resources I have, so I'm going to prioritize the quarry first. So, importer, I think I'm going to put it here. I think I can. it still should go through as a cable. You'll see what I mean. Oh no, I didn't need to break that. Never mind. So, cable here, and then importer here. Do I need you there? I don't think so. Okay. Alright, it's not that good looking, but I think we can make some kind of facade. Maybe that's the one that works. So, the facade. Let's see if it works through it. It doesn't seem to. It does not seem to want to work. It doesn't even let me click it. Not shift click, no, nothing. So I need applied A cables for that. So I'm not even gonna keep it because I'll probably never use it. I respect AE2 for being the original centralized digitized item system, but I don't particularly enjoy running around cables with channels all over my base and concerning with making a point to point to minimize the channel's usage on a section, and then accumulating the point to point in order to make a channel to the controller and all that. So yeah, it's, I understand it can be enjoyable, but at the same time it's too much struggle for me to still consider it fun. So I don't find it enjoying. I don't know. So let's fix that sawmill thing. We need some speed upgrades, which is this, I believe. So upgrades, we have nothing. Great. So we need more quartz, more glass, and improved processor. You know what? Let's do it this way. So one upgrade should be this. And then speed upgrade should be this. And sugar should be... Wait, can we make it in a machine to get more? Like, no, there's no thermal. Yeah, I can, oh, I get 4 sugar in a squeezer, mechanical squeezer. Yes, 4 sugar. Are you expensive to make? Energy battery, squeezer, obsidian, and diamond. How is the energy? Okay, so we need one of those trees. All right doesn't seem to be that expensive. I need to sleep. We're gonna do it because I keep forgetting to set up my sugarcane farm, which I'm also gonna do right now, because otherwise I will forget it for another 10 episodes. So yeah. I'm gonna need a lot of hemp for the... Ah! Damn it. Yeah. I heard him. Oh, right. Another one. I heard him, but I didn't think it was a creeper. I thought maybe it's like a zombie or skeleton or something like that. So I planted a sugarcane farm. This is all infinite water sources if you don't take the edges, so that's all good and dandy. Also cut some vines and tried to place them on the front, it doesn't work. You just can't place them. So I placed them on the sides, maybe they'll expand. Right, and we were looking for... oh yeah, the blue tree. More oil. Oh, there it is. Ta-da! Get a sapling? I did. Chicken. What are these? Bird of paradise. Nice. Actually, they're very nice. Yeah, this looks a bit more colorful. So, all of you go away. Rice, okay. Berries. Besides eating them that way, can we do anything important? I guess we do, so. Leave them. Right. Wood. Wait. To get that speed upgrade, we need a sugar and we needed this. No. Why do I have all those things? Okay. So you were made with crystallized. The wandering traders that show up at your home. Specifically the ones with rats, they're annoying. They're very annoying because their rats are turning my house into rat holes. And as you can see, it's not only one. And they can stack up because for some reason it's not limited to just one trader, let's say. No. It's actually, they can show up in more than one, so you can have two or three traders at the same time. One more and we're done. Okay. We needed some of those. And back to our refined. Oh no, we wanted the mechanical squeezer, which was two batteries. Mechanical squeeze up with this in the middle. Pum pum. Now I do believe this needs power. I am not 100% sure. Yeah. So down we go. We did this for sugar. So you get power. And now if we go here and say processing. Speed, sugar, you. Can't, it's always gonna ask for 6. one of you sugar. You make me 4 sugar cane. Sugar. So one of you make 4 sugar. We have everything for speed upgrades. So make me 10. Alright, go planet. Crafting. Machine doesn't accept item. Why not? Oh, because it's only one machine and you want to process all the things at once. So let's make another thermal furnace. In the meantime, we have to wait anyway, so move you. And you are a furnace. Pom pom. And you. And you're still configured? Yes. You need to be configured. And you come over here. And then I can take some of these patterns, like the glass and the silicone, put them here. And this will make silicone and glass, and this one will make the processors. Right? So they can share the load and do two stuff at the same time. So,
alright guys, so unfortunately we have reached our time limit, so this is it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it and we'll continue our immersive engineering evolution, hopefully getting the excavator up and running. So thanks for watching, you're amazing.